One in 10 TSA screeners called in sick over the weekend. That's up to 3 times the normal percentage. According to the agency itself, many employees are saying they just can't go on working without pay. On Friday, our Randi Kaye sat down with 5 federal workers, 1 from the EPA, 2 from the Bureau of Prisons, 1 from the TSA, and 1 from an air traffic controller. 4 are working without pay. 1 is furloughed. 2 are Democrats, 1 Republican, and 2 are independents. Here's that report.
How many of you are running out of money? Raise your hand. All of you.
Mara Perlman's son needs medication for ADHD.
I don't know how I'm going to pay the $250 a month for his medication. My husband and I have put ourselves on a macaroni and cheese and grilled cheese sandwich diet, so therefore the kids can eat.
Tom Ruiz is picking up extra cash playing guitar at a coffee shop, but that may not be enough to afford his regular MRIs for MS.
Those 3 added up to out-of-pocket costs, $550. And that's with insurance. But I have to get them. I have to make sure that this disease is held in check.
Kyle Coates, a divorced dad, may have to skip the 300-mile drive every other week to see his daughter.
I wouldn't have the gas money.
As of today, Kyle is broke.
You ran out of money today?
Today.
What are you going to do?
I absolutely did. I had like $20 left in my bank account, so called my parents and they're going to put in $300 for me today. So
when you know you have zero income but there is no end in sight, that's what becomes the problem.
And when a top economic advisor in the Trump administration suggested this is a paid vacation, this furloughed worker was furious.
And that's what really boiled my blood. But you got to understand the psychological impacts of this. Being at home, we feel undervalued, we're unappreciated, and that results in just low morale, of course.
Kyle, do you think that President Trump can relate to the situation that you're in?
I mean, we never relate to a guy that's living paycheck to paycheck. I don't think so. I don't think anybody in Congress could relate.
As a Trump voter, you don't agree 100% with what he's doing.
I don't agree 100%. I don't believe in holding anybody's paycheck hostage, Democrat, Republican. I don't care who you are.
What about Speaker Pelosi? Do you think she can relate to the position that you all are in?
No, and honestly, I don't think she cares. Every interview she does, and she's got this smirk on her face like she's winning. She's not.
Who do you blame for the position that you're in?
Congress as a whole. I would love to really point my finger a lot right now to Mitch McConnell, who refuses to allow a vote in the Senate.
I blame the entire leadership. As a leader, you don't get a chance to shift the blame. You have to take responsibility, period.
You did vote for Donald Trump. I mean, do you feel betrayed by this?
I definitely feel betrayed by him. You know, he talked about, supporting law enforcement. I'm a federal law enforcement officer not receiving pay. How's that supporting law enforcement officers? I blame him. I blame the Republican Party. I blame the Democrat Party.
You know, one of the hard parts about it is none of us are asking for handouts. We're just asking for our paycheck.
Randi Kaye, CNN, Dallas. Yeah.